Ladies and gentlemen, our program will begin shortly. All attendees will now be muted. As the program begins, we strongly recommend you select speaker view within Zoom for the optimal viewing experience. Please note that today's program is being recorded. Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to our International Women's Day event. My name is Laura Orizzi, and I'm Israel Bond's International Women's Division Chair. I'm delighted to welcome you all to this very special event hosted by our Israel Bond's Women's Division, partnering with World Zionist Organization in the UK. Our Women's Division is a vibrant group of strong, independent, and inspirational women who gather to share ideas, passion, and support the State of Israel through events, programming, and investments in Israel Bonds. The Women's Division hasn't only strengthened the relationship within this unique group, it's also strengthened their connection with Israel. The fact that we have come together from a number of countries this evening highlights what has made the Bonds Enterprise such an extraordinary success story. I'm very excited to introduce today's speaker, Dana International. Dana will be sharing with us her candid perspective on winning the Eurovision Song Contest, her life and career to date. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce to you our MC for this evening, Israel's former Eurovision host, Yigal Ravid. Yigal hosted the 1999 Eurovision Song Contest following Dana International's victory the year before. Yigal is a well-renowned journalist and broadcaster. Please welcome Yigal Ravid.
Laura, toda rabba. Thank you so much for this very warm introduction. I am Yigal. I'm talking to you from West Hollywood, Los Angeles, California, where I am right now, representing the Israeli public broadcast. It is a real honor and a big pleasure being today with you all over the world, meeting you people, both from the Israel Bonds and the World Zionist Organization. It is International Women's Day, a day that means so much for so many people, regardless of their gender. Many years ago, actually, how many? Let's point out, it's been exactly 23 years ago. Israel won the one and only Eurovision Song Contest that everybody would never forget in Birmingham, England, right where you guys are, most of you are, with the song Diva, sung by the one and only Dana International. She is with us today. Let's have a quick reminder first.
In 1998, a performer stand out with a stage presence, proving that Europe was a more open-minded place than we might have thought.
I represent Israel that accepts human beings, whoever they are.
Bonsoir, mesdames et messieurs.
Viva la Ria, viva Victoria.
Israel, Israel,
Israel,
Israel,
Israel,
Israel, right.
Just a little hiatus here, ladies and gentlemen.
We can't find them.
Thank you.
Now, she may sound like an airport, but she is, in fact, a diva. Please welcome the amazing Dana International!
Welcome, please, Dana International.
International.
Anna International.
Favoriet is de Israëlische inzending.
Eurovision Song Contest winner Dana International.
Well, now's your chance to ask her yourself. Dana International joins us today live from London.
I'm here with Dana International.
Dana International, it's...
Palot Pirelli. Dana International.
How exciting watching all those pictures, listening to the song, all those moments, 23 years on, Dana International, an icon for freedom, for social justice, for everything you can possibly think of, and one of the most prominent and outstanding Israeli figures for feminine for International Women's Day. Dana International joins us live from Tel Aviv, Israel. Dana, shalom, erev tov, my dear. How are you? מה שלומך?
Halan, ערב טוב, good evening. I feel fine. I'm happy to be with everyone. Exciting.
What does it feel like watching all those pictures 23 years on?
Woo! You know, as you get older, time passes by and I can't even think that 23 years has gone, you know. It feels for me like it's been 6-7 years ago.
Yeah, but it has been 6-7 years ago. It's been all those years. It never stopped, actually. You have become such an international figure for everything that we'd love to think that we stand for. What does it feel like being a symbol for International Women's Day? Do you consider yourself one?
Well, I consider myself as a woman. I consider myself as a soldier for women rights, for equal rights, for, you know, for tolerance, for whatever is good. I'm there.
It's been a very challenging year for all of us all over the world. All our viewers, look how many people gathered. Everybody is here to see you, Dana, with all the respect to the other organization that host us, they come to see you. So what kind of year was that for you? The international, I mean, this year, everybody suffered from COVID, Corona and everything. What have you been up to?
It's been a horrible year. I've been like a prisoner in my home. I hardly socialize. I am afraid of COVID-19, you know. I passed 50 years old, so I have to take care of myself. And to get used to this kind of behavior, of public behavior, of this kind of pandemic, it's like in the movies, you know, it's still unbelievable that there is a virus that stops the whole world, and it's amazing how we took life as granted, and now we appreciate it a bit more of what we've all suffered, you know. It's been, for me, a horrible year doing nothing. I had nothing to do, you know, no shows, no interviews, nothing. I had...
Did you get a vaccine?
What?
Did you get a vaccine?
No, tell you the truth, I haven't got it yet. I think it's from laziness, I don't know. I will get it, but I don't see any rush for me. I'm talking just about myself, so I know it's irresponsible a bit, but I'm telling you, I'm honest, so I'm not vaccinated yet.
Do you have plans getting it anytime soon?
Look,
everything is opening up, even, you know, even entertainment and culture, Dana, is opening up now.
I understood that we're going to have to live aside along with this disease, with this virus, COVID-19, and every 6 months we're going to have a new vaccination. So I'll take the new one.
So now that the country is opening
up. Sorry for bothering you, but the truth is, when the skies are open, I will be the first one to get vaccinated, to get out of Israel, to go back to do what I'm used to do. And I miss Europe so much. I miss London. Woo! You can't imagine how much. So
okay. When the Dana, skies it's open, international. It is today International Women's Day. We're watching all the shows all over the world. We're looking at the different website and newspapers. It means a lot. It feels like it means maybe a little bit more than it used to be in the past. What is International Women's Day? What does it mean to you personally, in person?
First of all, I think it gets more attention because of the Me Too movement. And as for myself, I have to be honest with you. I'm the kind of a strong person, and I am a soldier, as I said before. I'm the one that can help and encourage and talk and support women that are a little bit weak and disturbed, you know, and women who doesn't know what to do. And I empathize with them, but I can tell you about myself that it is very hard for me to accept, for example, a relationship where a woman gets beaten and this relationship goes on and on without the woman comes out and says, stop, it's enough, I'm leaving. All these kinds of examples, you know, so it's very important to have this International Women's Day, but I think it's more important to talk about it all year long, more than just one day in a year to give it this kind of attention. I think it's very important to talk about it every day, every week of the year, and to remind everyone that women are equal and deserve equal rights and much better behavior in many places, you know. We've been through Jeffrey Epstein and this kind of scams. And I think that women around the world should be united to support each other. And I really believe in my heart that women, unfortunately, don't know how much power they will have if they will really get united, you know. They are a little bit more than half of the population of the world. They must get their rights and power, and it's natural. It's us giving men privileges for thousands of years. It's going to be hard to change, but I think we are walking in the right way and in big steps, and I welcome and kiss each woman that cares about her sister.
You made a very tremendous change in your life. Your personal story is worldwide known. You've talked about it so many times, in so many ways, in different occasions. And like you mentioned your age a couple of minutes ago. What?
Also in different versions, you know, not to get
in different versions, exactly. do women talk to you about your story, about your personal story? Women of in this very international day, could you look back at women talking to you about your story, about your personal way of life?
I really understand your question. It's a fine question. If we were, you and I, just, you know, in intimate room, I will tell you everything, but, you know, we have to be a little bit politically correct. So I will start and say that there is no one kind of woman, you know. There are so many kinds of women around the world, and it's individual, you know, with any woman I meet. So I don't think that my intimate life is interesting for women. I think
is it
guys
more than guys? I mean, let me ask you. It's a very interesting subject, Dana. We never talked about it before. Do women talk to you about your life more than guys?
Guys like to talk about it a lot more, you know. Maybe it's turning on their limbos, I don't know. But women, you know, I think that they judge me, they judge my look, they judge my voice, they judge my hands, they, you know, it's natural, you know. It's not, I'm not a natural born woman, so it's natural to look at me, to be examined by all kinds of people. So when it comes to women, I think that they are more forgiven towards me, and they give me strength a lot more than guys. Guys are more shy to express. Only if you're alone, intimate, in a dark park, we can talk freely. But, you know, women don't see me as a threat or something like that. So they get excited by my bosom. They like my bosom, women.
They do.
They always say to me, "Wow, it stands up." So I tell them, for my kind of women, it never falls. I'm envy with false bosom.
You take care of that. Yeah. Well, actually, you know what, Dana, for women, you know, no matter where from and how they originated, you know, maintenance has a lot to do with age, comes with maintenance, you know. For women, for guys, you know, this has a lot to do with plastic surgery. What do you think? A lot of women, there is a lot of talk going on all over the world about, you know, plastic and cosmetic surgery and maintenance and operation and all of that. What do you think in this special day about that?
I think it's a disease. I think
it
since
is.
I think since the networks, you know, and the digital media and everything made people crazy, and all the filters, of course, that we are using in Snapchat, for example, we want to look like an illusion, like a fantasy, like we could never look, you know. So I think it's very dangerous. Of course, I do support, you know, some treatments for guys and women to look younger or better, or for self-confidence, of course. But you see more and more, the majority of them, they get addicted to this kind of surgeries, and you see duck lips like this all over. Yeah. And big lips and everything, and you see the same face in a lot of women. So I think it's like a disease, and it must be stopped. I think we should accept ourselves, you know, step by step. And I think it's a privilege to get to get older, and there are some things that we can do, like this lighting that I'm using right now. You saw me at the rehearsals, I was like a monster. And a little bit of makeup, a little bit of the right lighting can do what nature disappoints us, you know. I don't think we have to rush into cosmetic surgeries. And I do, I will do it, you know, at some point. I will have no choice, but I do recommend to go through these procedures at least when you're 60, 55, no. Not before. If you do this, at this before, point, if you start, you know, yeah, with plastic surgeries when you're 20, when you reach your 60s, there's nothing more you can do, and you look like
a monster. You just said before.
Monster.
Exactly. At this point, my dear, I'd like to, I'm being advised to tell our audience all over the world that this special discussion with you, that Dana has kindly agreed to take questions from all of us, from all of you, not only from me. So in order to take part in our Q&A session, all you're going to have to do to ask a question is to click on the raise hand button at the bottom of the participants list. If you're called upon, please accept the unmute button that comes later on. Just prepare questions. Dana, would you take questions from everybody? Would you, other subjects that you prefer to talk about? Subjects you'd like you not to talk about?
I would take even suggestions for sex, for booty calls.
So,
I would take everything, okay, you know. Surprise me.
Are you ready? Dana, is there something you haven't been asked before?
I don't think is there, so.
Is there a question that you've never been asked before that you want to be asked? Tell me, and I'll ask you that question.
I don't think so, because, you know, I've been interviewed for thousands of times, I think so. And it's always almost the same questions, the same interest about my transsexuality and stuff, you know. So I'm used to questions. I have like a kind of a drawer, so, and I pull answers, you know. I have few answers for each question.
Okay, so let's go ahead and see what the audience... Dana, let's go ahead. We're going to do our best, let me tell you. We've been trying our best. We've been advising our audience to come with the most astonishing and surprising questions possible. So the first one is going to be Joe Ozer from UK. Shalom, Joe. How are you? Hello, United Kingdom. This is United States, and this is Israel.
Thank you very much. My question will be a nice, easy one to start with. I just wanted to ask you how winning the Eurovision changed your life.
Slowly, please.
Just,
slower.
No problem. I just wanted to ask you how winning the Eurovision changed your life.
How what?
How winning the Eurovision changed your life.
Oh, okay. This is the one million times question. It changed my life in a way that I never participated. I've become a respectful person in my country and known, you know, around the world. I'm traveling a lot. I used to travel more. I've seen so many cities, so many things. I've been through so many stuff since I won Eurovision. And I have to thank God for sending me such a glorious winnings, so people remember me and inviting me after such a long time since I won Eurovision. So I no longer can go back to my to be a private person, especially in Israel. I walk around the street and everyone feels like they are my friend, they are my family, asking me questions, attending me, you know.
What kind of questions, Dana? People in the street, when they turn up to you, when they talk to you, what they talk about? What is the nature of the stuff people are saying to you?
Many of them just shouts, you know, you're a queen, we love you. But the courage one asked, I give you an example. I took a car of my friend, a very modest car, and a group of guys stopped me and say, wow, we don't believe this is the car Dana International drives with, you know. And I was shocked by what runs through people's minds. No, it's a car. It's a new car. So should I have a BMW or a Mercedes? What, you know, this kind of thing. And
what type of car was that anyway?
It was a Hyundai. A new Hyundai, it was a nice car, and I'm not a person of Rolls Royce, if you ask me to drive in Tel Aviv with Rolls Royce. So I told him, what do you expect?
If I was Dana International, I wouldn't, you know, go under BMW or, you know, or Mercedes or something like that. I mean, you know, this is, you are prestigious, you are class, you are the queen.
Well, my status doesn't cost me any penny, you know? You can't buy it with money. You have many artists that invest a lot of money in careers that their father or their friends gives them and nothing happens. You need to have luck and a bit of talent and a lot of brains.
Dana, our next question comes from Karen Flum. Karen, if you'll be kind enough to turn the video on, open your camera. There you are, Karen Flum. There you Hello. Are. Karen, where you are? From, where are you at? Where are you talking to us from?
Karen, you're beautiful.
Karen, you need to push the... Yeah, okay, go ahead.
Can you hear me?
Now we can. Go ahead, please.
All right, well, I'm here in Philadelphia, and we want to know, when can you come to Philadelphia? Because we would love to see you perform live once you're allowed to do it.
I love your accent, darling. Well, I really love your accent. You know, it's perfect. I love American accent. It's easier to understand you. I know Philadelphia from films, from stories, you know. It's a great place. I would love people to invite me over there, and I would come with pleasure, you know, in the cargo airplane.
Well, we have a standing invitation for you here in Philadelphia. I am very active with Hadassah here in Philadelphia, and also with PFLAG, the Parents and Friends of Lesbians and Gays. So you are loved.
Thank you.
Universally loved.
I really appreciate
you. Do you have, let me ask you, Karen, do you have Israeli, let's put it this way, Israeli entertainers, artists coming to Philly and entertaining you? Did you host Israeli music?
We need more. Artists? We need to engage the youth.
You need more.
We need to engage the young population, the young Jewish population in Philadelphia.
They have immigration.
Yeah. So you are Jewish and part of the LGBTQ community, right?
Which is I'm a supporter. I'm a supporter of the LGBTQ community. My daughter is a designer supporter for drag artists.
Okay,
wow, you
got
look
it now.
So young. Bless you and your daughter.
Thank you. Well, if you want to look at her website, it's AllisonFlamApparel.com. So, and she'll make you a jumpsuit, or she'll put some Swarovski crystals on your outfit.
Free advertisement, free publicity. That's what we are. That's what we're here for.
No, we want
you. You know, my father used to say, it goes in Hebrew, "Gvina chinam is rak b'malkodet achbarim." Free cheese, you get on in my trip. But look, Dana, here you go. We got a show for you coming up in Philadelphia, PA, Pennsylvania.
I would really come to Philadelphia. Especially.
Listen, Dana, you know, I lived in Los Angeles before, and I live here now again. And many of our friends say hi to you. They wanted me, some of them are present and watching us right now. And everybody is saying hi. And people actually texting me right now, when are you coming to Los Angeles?
Well,
do you have any plan? Or the United States at all?
I should have been there, you know, this year. I hope, you know, next year, this year is going to be different. And people have to understand that our skies are closed. You know, we don't have where to fly, how to fly, even if we want. People cannot invite us outside Israel. It's sad. But, you know, we look to the future. We are optimistic with the vaccine and everything.
Okay, our next question comes from Aviva Rahmani. Aviva Rahmani. Aviva, are you from Israel? Do you join us from Israel now? Shalom, Aviva.
Hi, Joe. Good to see you. Besides the emails, hi, Dana. It's
hi, baby.
Hi. I've been in London soon, 50 years. I love Israel, of course, but I've been stuck here for 50 years joyfully. I wanted to ask you something, as thank you for joining us today. How many cards did you get? Just pure curiosity. How many cards did you get from women today?
I don't understand you. I'm sorry.
How many cards did you receive today from women wishing you a happy
cards.
Women's Day? Cards. Wishes.
Ichulim. Kama katisim bracha. Ichulim.
Nada. Nothing. I'm just, I do not expect people to congratulate me. I am the one who did many video clips to support women. I accepted a request for the last 2 weeks, and I did a wonderful job, I think, to help women in this kind of situation. As for me, I didn't get any card. I'm sure the cards will get later to thank me for my participation.
Aviva, let me ask you, if you're still with us, are you involved in the women's organizations, both in the UK, in Israel, worldwide, whatever? I can't hear you. We can't hear you.
Then.
Yeah, no.
Yes, I am involved.
What were you saying? I'm sorry.
I'm involved on the council of the women division in London, in England.
Right. What do you do? What is your job? What are you guys doing?
Basically? I'm a businesswoman, and I have a real estate in Malabon. At the moment, it's very quiet, especially London.
It's great, you know. I think it's great because Dana wants to buy a house in London right now.
Well, here I am. I'll find you exactly what you want.
It's too expensive. London is the most. It's one of the most expensive places in the world. You know how much an apartment costs in London? No, I cannot afford it yet.
Come on now.
This is Women's Day or Real Estate Day, girls.
You should be able to afford one by now. Come on, Dana.
Okay. Aviva, toda raba. Thank you very much. It was great meeting you, getting to know you. And good luck. הרבה הצלחה בעבודה שאת עושה. Mayor Sherer is our next viewer, participant. Hello, Mayor. Here is Mayor joining us. Shalom, Mayor. And who's next? Who is Mayor and who's not Mayor?
My husband, Kvir, loves Dana, and he's going to talk.
Okay, go ahead, guys.
Hi. Dana.
Hello, guys.
I have to ask what it is. מה במאי? אני שומעת מכל מקום שבחלק.
אני שומעת מכל מקום. סיפור נפלא
שלי. אוקיי.
Let me just go ahead and tell our audience. This is part of Dana's routine.
Okay, so yes, I love you so much.
Thank you.
What else? Yeah, you're a big part of my life. All my almost childhood, I used to listen to you.
Thank you.
And what else? That's it. I'm really excited and overwhelmed, so I cannot.
Where are you guys at right now? Where are you talking to us from?
Boston,
Massachusetts.
Yes.
And how have you guys been together? For how long?
We've been together for 11 years. And married for 8.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Dana. Thank you. We love you.
Dana, why don't you just go ahead and tell us and tell them, of course, you have become one of the most leading voices of the LGBTQ community worldwide. Is it still the way? Is it still that way?
Yeah. It's getting harder. It's getting better. It's getting how to explain it. People listen to me now more than ever. You know, with age comes wisdom, as you say. Yeah, I do like to talk about it, but I do not like titles. I do not like these separations to communities. You know, we are the LGBTQ community, but what we are looking for are human rights, equality, you know, normal life like straight ones. And the things that we believe, the things that we fight for are suitable for many other groups. So I think it's better if we all get united and fight together, you know, because LGBTQ, it's saint, but we have the same goals as other discriminated groups and communities. So I would like to think of myself as a soldier of human rights, whenever they are, of a tolerant and et cetera, et cetera. No matter if you're gay or straight, no matter what color you are, no matter what race you are, I fight for everyone.
Nice said, Dana. Very emotional listening to you, that you're presenting, the way you talk about things. Have you ever, you know, we're not going to talk about politics today, but we are like 2 weeks away from, you know, the next whatever, number 4 Israeli elections. Have you ever considered joining, you know, being part of politics, make the change through politics, in the Knesset maybe?
You know, politics in Israel has become a joke. I think people should do a satire about Israeli elections 4 times in a row. in such a short time. I think it's madness. It cost billions of dollars, and we are the ones to pay for it in the bottom line, the citizens. And I think there has to be a solution for us to combine together to find the right government and to try at least to have a change. I need a change. I want a change.
Dana, we have one more person that would love to talk to you today, and this is Jo. Are we with her? Jo, Shalom Jo. Where is Jo? What does Jo stand for?
Shalom. I'm from Manchester, England. I just want to congratulate you on what you've done in your life to date. It is amazing, and you should be so proud of yourself.
That was rather a comment than, you know, an answer or than a question. We're talking to people from all over the world. Who? Lady Danielle? Danielle, is Dana still with us? I think her camera got... Yes, you are. Yeah. Okay.
Hi.
Okay. Shalom.
Shalom. I just want to say thank you very much for being there. You're a great inspiration to my life. And I was just wondering if you had any hard times like bullying at school and all that when you were younger.
Well, thank you for the first half. And of course I had and still having bad times like everyone, you know. It's a human being, life is hard and there is a lot on my mind, and sometimes I get depressed, sometimes I'm overjoyed, and I live my life. I try to be normal as much as I can.
We try. Normal life. Well, you do. Yeah.
And I do.
We all try. Until a bird meets a bird, right?
What? Ah, okay. They will not understand you.
Yeah, I know. Adrian would be the last.
You meant I see you again when a bird meets another bird?
I'm sorry.
And we keep normal until that moment when a bird meets another bird, right?
Try to imagine the crowd hears you say birds meet birds.
Dana, yeah, let me introduce to you. Let me introduce you. Introduce to you, Adrian.
Hello.
Hello, Adrian.
I just can't believe I'm talking to you right now. It's a dream come true. You have no idea. I'm gonna cry. It's unbelievable. 23 years ago, I watched you on television. I didn't see only the most beautiful woman in the world. I saw an angel. And you truly changed me, because when I saw you being so strong, I found myself and I fought for myself to become who I am. And today, because of you, thanks to you, I'm truly happy. So I've been looking in all books, all dictionaries, to find the strongest word I could tell you. And I have found one. Merci beaucoup. Merci. Toda raba.
I'm so excited. I want to hug you.
I have a question for you, Adrian.
You're from France, right?
Yes, I'm from France. Yeah, definitely. And there's one song that you sang, it's Nitzarti, but there's only another one, Iyetov Basov Iyetov. At the end, it will be fine. Yeah. And I want to, to ask you, at the end, it will be fine.
I don't know, it depends on us, human beings, you know? It depends on people, not on Earth, not on God. It's on us to get along together, to fight, to stop fighting each other, to stop racing each other, to stop competing each other, to stop hurting each other. It's on us to do the change. And I believe that step by step, it will happen.
I love you. Je t'aime. Je t'aime.
Merci beaucoup. Je t'aime aussi.
Dana, this was Adrian. He was our last participant. Very emotional, very exciting. Let me ask you another question before we have to say goodbye. We're talking now, this is March 2021, 23 years after your amazing victory and the wonderful career that you're having. What are your plans for the next year or so or two? Professional, musical plans? What do you plan doing soon?
Well, you know, I don't consider myself as Celine Dion. I consider myself as a singer and a person that can do other stuff. So now we're preparing a TV show, a documentary film. I have some business I have to do in London. It's been postponed by the COVID-19. I have a book that it's been written right now as we speak. And I just look forward to the future, to be healthy. I look forward for the world to feel happier and to go back and to hug people, to kiss people, to sit with people, to talk to people face to face and not to be afraid of some virus or, you know, I'm waiting anxiously for normal times to come back so I can be active, because the kind of stuff that I'm doing is, it meant to give people joy, excitement, happiness, not to sing sad and touching songs, you know. And I'm an artist that likes to bring joy and happiness and to celebrate each place I come and perform.
Dana, we are a couple of weeks away from the holidays, the high holidays, Passover, Independence Day and everything. Before concluding, I'd like to make a personal comment. We've known each other for so many years, and I've been following your career and interviewing you ever since, you know, Laila Tov Europa or whatever, or wow. Cinquilla or Saida Sultana, wow. You know, with everything. So you made this amazing, wonderful version of this great Israeli all-time song, Mi Haish, that you did last year or 2 years ago, right?
The song devastated me, the meaning. It's so short, but the meaning of the sentence, that's what I meant.
For me, you know, for me as a journalist. Said,
people are in charge of people. People can do the change. The change must come from us. Do not speak bad on other people. Do not do evil things. Just like the song, it's so short, it's so smart. And if we follow it, and even a part of it, the world is going to be a better place.
So at this time, I'd like to recommend all our viewers, once we finish this show, which is coming up right now, go ahead to YouTube and watch Dana International singing this wonderful, amazing cover, because it's not her original song. It's a song that's been done decades ago. And she has her own cover for that in a very, very interesting, very special interpretation that made her become... Go ahead, dear.
It's important to have translation.
Yeah, so this is true. It's a famous, it's a poem, basically. It's not just a song. It's a poem that got rhythm and music into it. And it's called Mi Haish, Who's That Man? And it's a very emotional song. It's not the happy, happy songs that we might have expected. And this is a very important transition for you as an artist and a musician. maybe stepping to the next stage in your career, Dana, right?
Yeah, yeah. I'm started to deal with things of the mind, things from the Bible, spiritual things. Yeah, you're absolutely correct.
Dana International, what can we wish you? What can you wish us, you know, watching you today at this International Women's Day?
Don't wish me anything. I wish the world to go back to itself, for us to have a healthy year, and that's all. First of all, to be healthy, to forget about COVID-19. I know it's going to be hard, but you asked me to wish something, so I wished.
Dana, let me tell you, I'm coming to Israel for the holidays. I'm taking you to get the vaccine, you know. You can't just, you want to go abroad, you want to go on with your career, you have responsibilities, and you are a role model. You need to get the vaccine, dear.
I will have to get the vaccine, even if I want or not. People are waiting for me abroad, and I need this green passport, you know. But I'm not in such a hurry because I'm so alone with my dogs. I have 3 dogs. They are my children. I don't go out a lot. There was a quarantine after quarantine after quarantine. So always with mask and everything. But there is no excuse. There is no excuse. The vaccine will get to my body. It's going to be photographed and you're going to watch it. It's going to be funny.
Dana Yakirati. קודם כל, תודה רבה. Thank you so much for taking the time, being today, being tonight here with you, with us. Thanks to the Israeli Bonds and the World Zionist Organization, the 2 organizations that we were privileged to talk to and be guests of.
Thanks, everyone. I love you all, and a special thanks to Zonenstein. Kisses. It was a pleasure to talk to you.
So since you mentioned Zonenstein, it is my pleasure to introduce to you before, just by saying goodbye, Toda Dana. It was my personal honor, really, really honor and a big pleasure talking to you and meeting all those wonderful people all over the world, especially the UK. So before saying goodbye.
And I'm going to watch now the interview with Oprah Winfrey.
Go ahead and tell me what you think later on. It's been a crazy interview. It's a 2-hour thing, Dan, I warn you. You need a lot of patience, you know. So, for concluding, let me introduce to you the head of the World Zionist Organization in the UK, our old friend, Yitzhak Zonenstein, bevakasha.
Thank you very much, Igal. You were so right. We have known and created together for many years. And yet, the wonderful Dana International is exciting at every event over and over again. So I'm sure speaking on behalf of the hundreds of participants now in the Zoom and the thousands who have shared on the rest of our social media channels, when I say the wonderful hour we had with you, Igal Ravid and Dana International will not soon be forgotten. Dana, on International Women's Day, which we commemorate today, you have given us an experience, empowerment and inspiration for all the women and for us, the men, who have a lot of work ahead of us. I would like to say a big thank you to our partners in the Israel Bonds, to Joe Ozer, to Orit Osherotsky, and to Zara Landesberg. And to my partners in the World Zionist Organization here in Britain, to Sivan Atzmon, and to my colleague Dima Mevzos. There are many more who worked behind the scenes for the success of this event, and special thank you to my friend Shai Kerem, the personal manager of Dana International. We at the World Zionist Organization promise to continue to bring you experiences and thrills from Israel all year around, and hope to see you with us in the Hebrew studies and all the other activities. Shalom, leitraot, Have a great evening, everyone, and thank you for being with us. Thank you.
Shot to view, she shot to view, she fired a team.